thank you all for being a part of this wonderful night. I know many of you are still taking your seats. We're about to do the student awards. My name is Charles Trillingham. I am the executive producer at NWCN and chair of the student awards for the Natus Northwest region. We begin tonight's event by congratulating our 2015 high school and college award winners and nominees. The work they are doing is more important than ever as our industry works to evolve with the times. Much of what these students use technology and social media for, we as professionals are still trying to grasp. I urge you to consider reaching out or even mentoring a student or new professional. You might just find a mentor in return. You'll see some of the incredible work by these students in just a few minutes in a special video montage. I ask each winner, as I call your winning entry and high school, please make your way to the stage, up the left side here, and accept your award. And please remain on the stage until the very end. Now let's get to the categories and the nominees. We begin with high school news, general assignment, serious. The nominees are South Kitsap High School with Human Rights Conference, Skyline High School with Stay Safe Skyline, and the winner is South Kitsap High School. Now to news, general assignment, light. Our nominees are Timberlake High School with Speed Limit Finally Changed, Skyline High School with What is Homecoming, South Kitsap High School with SK versus Fallon, and Timberlake High School again with Basketball Triumph. And the winner is Basketball Triumph, Timberlake High School. Now arts and entertainment. The nominees are South Kitsap High School with Hope for Kids, the MAPS Media Institute with Darby Rodeo, and the MAPS Media Institute with Logger Days. And we have two winners in this category, Darby Rodeo and Logger Days from the MAPS Media Institute. On to sports now, and the nominees are South Kitsap High School with Father-Son Team, Bonnie Lake High School with One Step Ahead, South Kitsap High School with Ready for College Sports, and Timberlake High School with Timberlake Girls Basketball. And the winner is Timberlake High School. Now to short form fiction. Our nominees are Ballard High School with Fly Me to the Moon, Ballard High School with Stolen, the Seattle Academy of Arts and Sciences with Ginger and Flynn, and the Seattle Academy of Arts and Sciences with Plain Love. And we have two winners in this category as well. Plain Love by the Seattle Academy of Arts and Sciences and Stolen by Ballard High School. In the category of short form nonfiction, the nominees are Ballard High School with Audio Input, Ballard High School with Raven Rock, Ballard High School with GeoForce, A Journey to Understanding, and Northwest Documentary with Burl Patrol. And the winner is GeoForce, A Journey to Understanding from Ballard High School. Now to long form fiction. Just one winner, just one nominee and one winner. DJ McCoy with Generation RX. On to long-form nonfiction. The nominees are Skyline High School with Behind the Scenes for NorbCam Orange Flush. I don't know what that is either. Ballard High School with Clipped Wings. And the winner is Ballard High School with Clipped Wings. The next category, a favorite among the judges, music video. The nominees are Skyline High School with I Never Sleep, Bonnie Lake High School with I Will Never Be, and the winner, I Never Sleep by Skyline High School. The next category is public service announcement. The nominees are Ballard High School with Food Lifeline, Ballard High School with Membership, and Skyline High School with Don't Fade Away. And the winner is Skyline High School with Don't Fade Away. Now to public affairs, community service. The nominees are the MAPS Media Institute with Education Program, Skyline High School with Hooked, and the winner is Skyline High School with Hooked. Rolling right along, the next category here, Animation Graphics Special Effects. The nominees are the Seattle Academy of Arts and Sciences with Slipper Ballet, and King's High School with Save Yourself. And the winner is King's High School with Save Yourself. Now to photographer editor. The nominees are South Kitsap High School, Avery Krumzik Compilation. I apologize if I got that last name wrong. And Ballard High School with Clipped Wings. And the winner is Ballard High School with Clipped Wings. Finally, a very important category, writing. The nominees are Ballard High School with Stolen, South Kitsap High School with Curtis Keat Compilation, and Ballard High School with Clipped Wings. And the winner is Stolen by Ballard High School. Congratulations again to all our high school winners and nominees out in the crowd tonight. I ask you all now to direct your attention to the screens on each side of the stage as we take a look at the incredible work of these high school students.
All these issues within society and these beautiful people all around these conferences are sweet, and they care about everybody, and they help change the world.
Our club members from GSA and Builders of Unity headed over on December 5th.
So for a student with a disability, it's an especially challenging sport, but Zan Rose, a senior at St. Mary's High School, is one of the few who has taken on the challenge of participating in basketball with a disability.
Well, he played basketball in the middle of July, Darby, Montana.
You'll get some serious action.
For anyone who has ever played sports, you know how unusual it is to be on a championship team.
It's been really good. We've been very successful.
This year, the Lady Tigers of Timberlake have wowed many crowds with their relentless domination, and as their...
We're very impressed with the low bid and fast turnaround.
Well, my company prides itself on our low competitive prices.
We're there, and we're still getting lectures, so we're still getting all the education we need on what we're looking at.
GeoForce is all about getting out in the field and actually seeing some rocks, walking around them, getting your hands on them, maybe making a map.
Hey man, check it out. Speed in a capsule. Three, four, five of these, off you go.
Into the Boy Scouts before my kids are eligible to join. That's where they need to go next, and we're going to be pushing them all the way. They're going to take a lot of heat for this.
I miss you too. I never sleep, but I'm always dreaming. Baby, come and touch my fingertips. I've been dead for as long as I can.
I used to be the girl everyone looked up to, the one everyone came to for advice, but now I'm the one that they tell you not to go near. I don't know what happened or where I went wrong. I mean all the drink.
Self-esteem is something that we want in kids, but it's not something that can be handed to them. It's something that they actually have to go out and earn. Self-esteem is the byproduct of hard work well executed. These kids...
Sir, how'd you find me?
I watch. And I see who comes in and out.
So, you're looking for a piece.
How about that fantastic work? All right, as these students exit to the stage to the left, please give them another hand. And they're just in high school. Amazing. Now to the very best in college from around our region. Again, I ask each winner, as I call your entry in school, please make your way to the stage to accept your award up the left-hand stairs here, and please remain on the stage until the very end. Okay, here we go with the first college category, newscast. The nominees are Oregon State University with Beaver News, and the University of Montana with UM News. The winner is Oregon State University. Now to news, general assignment, serious. The nominees are the University of Montana with construction jobs and the University of Montana with mystery odor. And the winner is construction jobs from the University of Montana. Now to news, general assignment, light. The nominees are the University of Montana with bridge gravity device, Washington State University with Backyard Railroad, and Washington State University with Wine Science Center. Sounds good to me. And that's your winner, folks. Wine Science Center from Washington State University. On to the category of arts and entertainment. The nominees are the University of Montana with Dance on Location, and Washington State University with Moscow Weaver. And the winner is Washington State University with Moscow Weaver. Now to sports. Our nominees are Washington State University with WSU Bat Lab, and the University of Montana with Softball Field, and the University of Montana with Hurling Championships. Not curling, hurling. And the winner is Washington State University with WSU Bat Lab. Continuing on now to short form nonfiction. Our nominees are Brigham Young University, Idaho, with BYU Idaho Student Activities Leadership Profiles, Chase Harrison. Washington State University with Cuba's Restoration Project. And Washington State University with Nick Taniello story. And the winner is Cuba's Restoration Project, Washington State University. On to long-form nonfiction. The nominees are the University of Montana with Distracted, Eyes on the Road, the University of Oregon with True Fighters, the University of Oregon with Discovering James Blue, and Pacific Lutheran University with Waste Note, Breaking Down the Food Equation. And the winner is the University of Oregon with True Fighters. Now, public affairs, community service. Our nominees are the University of Montana with Sexual Assault Awareness, Brigham Young University, Idaho with United Way PSA, and BYU Idaho with Alumni P2B Promo. And the winner, United Way PSA by BYU Idaho. Now to the category, animation, graphics, and special effects. BYU Idaho with Animal Science Promo, and BYU Idaho with Food Science Promo. The winner, Animal Science Promo, Brigham Young University, Idaho. Last category now for college, photographer editor. Our nominees are BYU Idaho with housing and student living, university relations, creative services, and Washington State University with the Daily Evergreen. And the winner is BYU Idaho. Now, obviously, all of these kids could not be here. I'm sure many of them are taking finals as we speak, but please give a hand to our nominees and our winners who were able to take the stage tonight. And again, I ask you all to direct your attentions to the screens on each side of the stage as we take a look at another short video of the incredible work of these college students.
Good evening and welcome to the Beaver News. I'm Anna Singer.
And I'm Kiana Hatch. We're so glad you could join us. Smoking is a bad habit that far too many people pick up, and it can be very difficult to quit.
The construction bill is more than $26 million.
$2.5 million of those dollars are right here in this project going to creating jobs.
UM Planning and Construction oversees all projects on campus, and Associate Director Kevin Kresbach says he sees a rock.
Pop goes the cork of a delicately aged wine brought to this classroom not only to drink, but to dissect the flavors, smell the aromas, and above all,
266,000 acres
to learn from.
The whole deal with spinning is just is taking this fluff, this breakable fluff, and adding twist to it. And that's really all my job is as the spinner, is to.
Most, baseball is just a game. But for the Sports Science Bat Lab at Washington State University, baseball is a business.
The purpose of the Sports Science Lab.
We are walking.
It's always going to be there for everybody, that drive. You want to win for everything that's happened. You want to just, like, let out all the pain.
Strong communities are made of strong people. That's why every dollar you donate to United Way goes directly to helping the people in our community by assisting local education, providing financial stability for individuals and families who are...
We're not given the solution. We discover it. When we were children, we couldn't help but to question the world around us. Exploration came natural. As we build our lives, we must work to continue questioning, exploring.
Let's give it up for Mark from Washington State University, who stood up here all by himself while he accepted his awards. Mark, congratulations again. And please, a loud round of applause for all of our student nominees and winners. One day they will be our colleagues, friends, and maybe even our bosses. I also have the honor tonight of announcing our Northwest Scholarship winners. This is one more way Natus invests in our next generation. Joining us on stage now are the Natus Northwest 2015 scholarship winners. This is the 30th year Natus Northwest will award scholarships, and since 1985, Natus Northwest has given out nearly 90 scholarships to worthy college students. This represents more than $150,000 to deserving college students in our five-state region. This year's scholarships also include the fourth year for a special award designed to honor Trisha Moen, the inspirational Como TV news producer who died in 2011 after losing her battle with cancer. The scholarship applicant who was chosen to receive the Trisha Moen Memorial Scholarship is Matthew Salzano from Pacific Lutheran University. Matthew has been a vital part of the crew for News at 9 on PLU's student television and was arts and entertainment editor for the student newspaper. Matthew is a second-generation TV broadcaster. His mother worked at KHQ, And Matthew's first stint on TV was the day he was born. The kicker that night on KHQ was a shot of Matthew in his mother's arms in the hospital. He told the scholarship judges that he looks forward to telling important stories that help others interpret the world. Please give Matthew another round of applause. Our second NATIS scholarship winner is Andrew Anderson from the University of Montana. Andrew likes working in a TV control room. He has been preparing his career in TV by working as a production assistant at KPAX TV in Missoula and also working for Grizz Vision, the live sports production arm of UM. Andrew had the judges in stitches when he told them that one of the top skills needed to prepare for a career in TV was to learn how to wrap cable over and under. Please give Andrew another round of applause. And our final NATIS scholarship winner is Ariana Lake, also from the University of Montana. Ariana started her college career as a science major, but has recently learned that sharing stories is her real passion. She's grown in that regard by working as a reporter intern at KPAX in Missoula. Ariana also served as host for MTV Extreme Cribs. She told the judges she plans to be bold in chasing the important stories. Please give Ariana another round of applause. And once again, join me in congratulating these college students who represent the next generation of excellence in television in our region. In short order, you may be competing with them for a gold statuette as well. And that's my time. Please welcome to the stage the incoming president of the Northwest Chapter of the National Academy of Television Arts and Sciences, Joan Carter Hanson.
Good evening. Thank you and welcome to the Northwest Emmy Awards. I'm honored to take on the role of president, following in the footsteps of someone as amazing as Dick Splitstone. Dick led the chapter, stressing our role to recognize excellence, to serve our industry, and to mentor the next generation of professionals. If I can do half as well as Dick did, our organization will be well served. Dick, thank you very much. Toward that end, I'd also like to encourage each of you to send me your thoughts, what you'd like to see our chapter do better for you. My email is on the NATIS Northwest website. Please let me know what you think about our event tonight, about the nomination parties, and especially if you're interested in joining us as a volunteer for NATIS. You know, it does take months of preparation and hundreds of volunteer hours to get to this point tonight. I would like to have our Board of Governors, our regional chairs, and our committee chairs and their committee members please stand to be recognized. Everybody? Thank you. I'd also like to give a special thanks to the heart and brain of our chapter, Diane Bevins, and her team, who keep our organization running, and I especially would like you to give them a round of applause. Now I need your help with one more thing. Being a nominee is something very, very special. It takes a great deal of work and effort to be a nominee. If you have been nominated tonight, this is your chance. Please stand for me. Nominees? Up, come on. Get up. Okay, before you sit down, please repeat after me. I would like to thank my colleagues, my friends and family, my spouse and or significant other, if I happen to have one, for this honor. All right, you may be seated. And now that you've all had a chance to thank that important person in your life, should you win, you can keep your speech really short. So our moment is almost at hand, and I'd like to thank you for your attention. I look forward to hearing from your thoughts. Please send me your emails. I look forward to serving you in the year to come. The show is going to begin in a few minutes, but before we do that, I would like to take a special time to thank the Silver and Gold Circle recipients. They are an amazing, amazing group of people. We hold a Gold and Silver Circle event last night, the night before the Emmys, to honor those people, to give them a chance to give a speech, as they don't give a speech. Now, we will recognize them tonight. But I did want to share a clip with some video of what we did last night. And next year, I encourage you to come. It's a wonderful event, and it's absolutely these are absolutely amazing people. So enjoy tonight's event. Thank you very much, and take a look at the video.
All of our inductees, and thank you for all you've done, not only for our industry, but for your communities. It's that commitment to excellence in both that complements those who came before you and inspires those of us who follow you. We thank you, and we salute you.